I said, he's on guard. He pulled you out of dark waters. There were dark waters, the Lord said, he pulled you out, he drew you unto himself. And it's he that named you faith. And the name that was given to you with faith is the name that God has called you. God gave you your name. And he has drawn you unto himself, and he has given you your name. His name. His name is faith. God has given you his name. And now he will be your husband. And God says, he will break this torment off your mind. That no longer will this be a worry in your mind. Who is my mother and who is my father? Or what are the dark waters that are around you? And even though you've talked before, you tell you what these dark waters are that you might understand. But the Lord says it has not been time for you to understand. But because of your strong nature, you have taken matters in your own hands. And the Lord will not allow it. It will be in his hands. Used for that lowercase g is again Elohim. what is right by judging in favor of the wrong. Now I'm going to read from King James. God and the word for God here in Elohim. Stand in the congregation of the mighty. He judges among the gods. And I added, saying, how long will you judge unjustly and accept the persons of the wicked? Selah. At this celestial Nuremberg, comparing it to Nuremberg courts, he accuses the various national deities of misrule, of abuse of powers delegated to them. And you know, we know the word of God. We know that the civil authorities are just as accountable to God as God's spiritual authorities. They're showing what's deplorable. There was no regard for morality in pagan cultures, highly religious though they were. More like they were nearly superstitious. Superstition is always a worship of Satan and his divine powers. A Christian should be superstitious about nothing. But then we're saying, if I'm superstitious about this thing, then Satan has power with that thing. Okay. In these verses 3-5, God confronts them of their duties to mankind. Defendants, defenseless, the fatherless, and the forgotten. Passion translation. The disenfranchised and the destitute. Your duty is to deliver the poor and the powerless. Liberate them from the grasp of the wicked. You continue in your darkness and ignorance while the foundation of society are shaken to the core. We were singing that song this morning, I Know My Redeemer Lives. Of course, we know that was Job's faith declaration, what God got a hold of him. But in that song, it describes God forming the foundation of the earth. Who is that? Try to get me. I haven't been with the phone people yet. It's still not working.
You can't do it. She's on the count.
Yeah, I'm on the count. Okay.
That's what I was doing, but it's not doing.
Okay, King James. Verses 3-5. Defend the poor and fatherless. Do justice to the afflicted and needy. Deliver the poor and needy. Rid them out of the hand of the wicked. They know not, neither will they understand. They walk on in darkness. All the foundations of the earth are out of course. Another translation reads, rid them out of the hand of the lawless. This is the work of the judges. This is the work of the civil authority. This is the work of the rulers of the earth. As they stand before God, they will be judged. I said, the rulers of the earth will be judged when they stand before the court of heaven by this work. I speak to Governor Newsom. I speak to the Congress of California. I speak to the mayor of New York and the governor of New York. I speak to the mayor of Chicago. I speak to the governor of Oregon and the mayor of Portland. I speak to the mayor of Seattle. I speak to the judges, and I tell you that you will be judged because you Romans. All the foundations of the earth are out of course. Well, something's going on. We've got fires burning in California. We've got storms coming into the, of course, I know it's September, storms always come in. Coulomb says we're going to have blizzards all winter. And of course, everybody's getting saved to the glory that it's climate change. And that's the spirit of Baal behind climate change. All the foundations of the earth are out of course. That's the sign. That's the sign that the judges of the earth are out of alignment with God. The foundations of the earth were laid at the time of the singing of the stars and angels. The earthly judges are oblivious to the foundations of the earth being shaken because of their sin before God. Meaning, California is crying, help us, help us, help us, put out our fire. And I say, repent, repent, repent. And I might say, God, deliver. Now, I saw on 712 yesterday, just happened to turn it on at that very moment, I saw suddenly 3,000 people were baptized at a church service. They usually baptize 300 or 400, they baptized 3,000 Sunday morning. They had only 712. Okay, so see this happened, we're talking about that part at the same time, the burning of San Francisco. There was a revival of hope. Okay? So out of this burning of God's judgment, which is the only thing that will bring people to repentance, people are getting saved. God's judgment is our laying his love for us. If that's the only thing that will save us, then God's judgment will cause us to turn to him. Ignorant and senseless. These judges carry on blindly, undermining the very basis of earthly society, which is what the foundation of the earth is set on. God's law, God's order, God's cleanness, not the uncleanness of the world. They have thrown away the very foundation of the world in their rulings, and God's foundation of the world, and God has rendered a verdict for these people, and it is death. They walk around in bewilderment. I stand before God and his heavenly court today, because see, I believe the court is ongoing. I don't believe what they got says, hey, I'm going to open up my courtroom, and today we're going to have court. No. I think that the judge of the whole earth is capable of judging the whole earth and running it too. And I charge the justice system of the United States of America with this word. it is. I said it. And we're watching, we have to know the word of God. Nobody in this church is crying out, "Oh God, have mercy on California." I said, "Oh God, save them. Oh God, cause there to be a revival to come forward, that these people will repent, because they are accountable for electing these people and coming to your freedom with us." Because they are politicians, if they were concerned about these people's vote, they wouldn't do these evil things. Because all they care about votes. If any man's work abides, which he has built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. There is a reward from heaven. We have studied it, we have seen it, people who come on to heaven have seen the reward from heaven. That prophet told me I was going to have a reward. Well, you know, I didn't tell y'all about that. Mm-hmm. I did not do that. He told me, if any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. When it, you know, the intercessors, you know how dear they are, they cry out, "Oh, pray that these fires stop." Mm-mm. No. If we pray, and you got the power to pray it, you know? Mm-hmm. You have the power to pray these fires stop. But what you're doing is you're giving permission for the evil to continue, because God's doing it for the judgment. Mm-hmm. When God is dealing in judgment with someone, don't go rescue them. Mm-hmm. But don't go kick them while they're down either.
Amen. That's right.
If you kick them while they're down, then you're going to be down next.
That's true.
You'll never kick someone when they're down. But you better be careful you don't pray about it. Before God's finished with his work with them, when you go, "Mine," they're going to turn right back around and they're going to do it again because you prayed about it. But that probably don't want our poor babies to suffer, do we? No. We don't want people that we love to suffer. But we have to know and understand that God loves them more than we do. And he knows what it takes to get them to where he can save them without us interfering. I told y'all the story, you know the story that fits in here, about what my brother got. He was 48 years old and had a heart attack. And he had been dead 3 days before they got him. And the Lord speaks, you know, he tells me sometimes before we're not there. So I went to the Lord, I said, "That was great." I said, "Lord, why didn't you tell me he died?" He said, "Because you would have prayed for him, and I would have had to let him live." You see how much power your prayer has? You would have prayed for him, and I would have had to let him live. And at that moment in his life, he was clean and saved and walking with God. Mm-hmm. I don't know that he could have kept on. Be careful how you pray.
Mm-hmm. That's right. It's salvation first, always.
He himself shall be saved, mm-hmm. yet so as by fire. I pray for my brother his whole life. He was one of those people of first strength, he came out and called. Mm-hmm. not written in your law. I said you are God's. Lowercase g. Jesus said that.
Look at that.
Jesus, John 10, 34 through 36. If he called him God, okay, this is John speaking. I'm still in scripture here. If he called him God, and you took the word of God and came, and the scripture cannot be broken. Mm-hmm. I can use any of that. Okay. The only other scripture that is written, you are God, is in Isaiah 41, 2 through 3. And God, first of all, he's given a blessing on Israel, and then he's rebuking them for anyone who doesn't, who comes against his blessing. That's the only other place in the Old Testament that ye are God is used. Jesus is quoting Psalm 82, verse 6. Now, you, I know a lot of people can explain that. I'm not going to try. The leaders of Israel were called princes, as well as the leaders of the 12 tribes. They were called prince. Number 62. They rose up before Moses with certain of the children of Israel, 250 princes of the assembly, famous in the congregation, men of renown. Okay, because he's talking about two different things here. He's talking about, I have said you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High, but you shall bow like men and fall like one of the princes. So there's really three types of people there that he's talking about. Four, captains of thy own man. Just giving y'all information, I have no intention of addressing that. Now, in verse 8, we have a verdict of God's judgment. A death sentence is passed. Despite their supernatural right, they are to be stripped of their privileges and suffered the degrading penalty of death. Now, there is an aura around ribbon, I'm thinking fire ribbons got all that.
And the fire's burning in paradise again.
I'm getting fire ribbons go to the Pentecost.
Oh, Pastor Carolyn, I drove a couple to the airport yesterday, and the gentleman, he is originally from Colombia, and I mentioned to him, you know, because they were going to California, and I mentioned to him when the governor had approved and everything, and he said, "What?" I mean, he got furious, and he said, "As long as I've lived in the United States, and they are going to allow something this defiled to come on American soil," he said, "that is communism," and he said, "I fought to come out of that, and they're bringing it on American soil."
Today, I charge that the higher courts, whatever manner they operate in all of their hierarchy, they will either shut this thought down, or they're going to come up under this check. I declare it.
Yes.
We do not have to throw up our standing hands and say, "Oh, woe is me. California just passed it, so now everybody else is going to pass it." No!
It must be revoked.
Well, it's to protect the LGBTQ. We just came that close yesterday. Our State Board of Education voted down curriculum that's pro-LGBTQ. They voted it down, and climate change. I mean, it was, it's right now, it's 9-6. There's 9 Republicans, 6 Democrats on the State Board of Education.
I speak to those 6 Democrats, and I'm telling you that the fireball did you.
Yes. Amen. Yes. Kelly agrees with you.
Who?
Kelly Moore, she agrees with you. She says, "Send fire to the pedophiles."
We need the power to heal, we need the power to what he wrote this song. He saw a vision of God judging the whole earth. And then he saw God making his judgment based on God's reasons for judging. And then he saw God's verdict of his judgment. And then God's declaration of that judgment. And then he came back and he declared it with a prophetic voice to send it forth. Bell is authority and his power because somebody told you you didn't?
Same thing. Obama, Pelosi, and Camilla.
Kelly's in there with it?
Yep, she's in it.
Obama and Hillary and...
No, Pelosi and Camilla. Kamala. I said it wrong.
Lord,
I rebuke you.
Endless prophecy, God says, I've been waiting and waiting and waiting on my church, but I'm
But the ones that are crooked.
Bill Gates.
Bill Gates.
The Lord rebuke you. World Health Organization. The World Health rebuke you. The Lord rebuke you. The United Nations. The Lord rebuke you. The Lord rebuke you.
Yes, Lord.
To all who call evil good and good evil, the Lord rebuke you.
Yes, Lord. China.
The Lord rebuke you.
Yes, Lord.
The Illuminati.
The Lord rebuke you.
Everything demonic.
The Lord rebuke you.
And she just said she loves you. She said she hasn't changed a whole lot.
Who was that?
Kelly Moore. Austin Klein.
So those who have the privilege of God's office, whether civil or spiritual,
tell me later.
They will receive the judgment of a coming before heaven. It's not something he's going to do. It's something he has already done, and he said he's not going to wait on his church anymore. He's going to go ahead and do it. He was waiting on us to come into agreement, but then everybody's walking around like worms. Asaph was given a vision of that court on the day the verdict was rendered. The verdict's already been rendered. We just got to release it. 1 Corinthians 15:24. Then comes the end. 200. I don't know what she did or thought that was, but I think more money than we did. And the Lord is giving you that time that you desire with him. I see they're making a place for you in the business, because somebody has to keep their books, even if they're closing down. Somebody has to keep their books. So they're going to make a place for you. It won't be as many hours. There'll be less hours. I see you looking puzzled. You're in agreement, okay. But the Lord says he's releasing this more money, some money to you. And he said this is giving you that which you desire, because you just desire to be in the presence of the Lord and his anointing. That's all that's in your heart, is just to be in the presence of the Lord. Lori, you know that heart that you have for the underprivileged, the needy, the orphans, the street people. Okay. That's turning that back up in you. And you're going to be ministering in the power of God to people. You've been through some really rough times. Through the rough times, God has worked a grace in you. And he's worked a lot of flesh out of you. And I see you will be one that That's why I'm trying to do a unity in your marriage. Or you're not on my sweet creek. Or y'all just flow together easily. All conflicts raising children. Everything you positive in them, you will see fruit of it. Sometimes you talk too much to them. Nobody else in this room has ever had that.
Absolutely not.
Is that how it is?
Absolutely.
Or is it every word you positive in them, so therefore fruit. And there's one grandchildren. The Lord says they need to talk about something. There's no one to talk to. The Lord says, listen. Listen. That's what I'm calling for grandchildren. Listen. Listen. None of them are lost. Mm-hmm. They're just all on each one of their journey, fighting the spirit, the spirit of the age. Mm-hmm. And that's where your heart cries now, for those grandchildren. How many of you? Do you think it's spirit of worry? Worry won't figure anything out. I want that you will give him a clear vision, a clear understanding, a clear direction. Make it totally clear to him, Lord. Every step of his life, every day of his life. Yes. I know he's in your will now. There's a decision you're trying to make, Jesus. Lord says he's already told you what to do. And if you do what he tells him, you won't be worried anymore.
Thank you.
We ain't getting paper on my head. But I've seen paper, but you can hurry.
Yeah. They ever do the, what's that, free money, the people.
Okay, Gary, this is the way you're gonna go into the next years of your life. And you'll not be more than that.
You go, girl.
That you're gonna be running. And you may have to go this fast, some of them are running, but you're still running. You're not walking, you're not standing, you're running.
Amen.
Pastor.
If not before the end of this month, at least definitely not in, there won't be anything for me to do with Terry, Deputy Warden Office.
Okay.
So the projects are wrapped up. And of course, she's fixing to go into the transition on October 1st. She's not subleasing anymore with that other company. She would be leasing directly from the management there at the building. She's not moving. The lady that wanted to come on board wanted her to move is not going to. So she's staying where she is, which is a good location. I'm happy about that. So her rent is going to increase substantially. You had prophesied that she would get corporate accounts. The other woman that was supposed to come, the other CPA to come with her, has corporate accounts, but now she's not coming. So,
that one will be not available to give.
So, but anyway, I think my assignment is about her. I see like a gate that's not closed, it's like it's partially open, so I don't know if she'll have something that may come up at some future.
Yeah, okay, she'll always call you.
But when she gets in the bag, yeah, but anyway.
How old are we now, Joanne?
Next month, I'll be 73.
73. And you're not going to have a retirement. You've got to cut you. He cut you from a different call.
Mm-hmm. It's like I needed something else to do. Going there and helping her was such a blessing. Of course, we pray together and different things. It's just been real.
Okay. Listen to me. When God cut you, he cut you from a different call.
Yes.
And there will be no retirement in your life. God is going to take that apostolic authority that you carry, and you're going to be in charge of a project. And I see young children involved, but you're going to be in charge of this project. And I see you running. So don't worry about us coming back or retiring. It's not in your future. God's got a job for you. He will always have a job for you. It'll just open up just like We want you to